Today we're going to talk about using the 34-330A low voltage burden current shunt to measure current in a circuit. The reason you'd want to use this current shunt instead of the DMM as shown here is this DMM introduces about a 1 volt voltage burden to the current measurement. So what's happening here is you can see on the bottom DMM it actually drops almost a volt across the DMM. Now we have a 1 ohm load in the circuit here and it's 3.3 volts being applied, and you can see the current is actually about an amp below what it should be. That's because this other volt is being dropped by the DMM shown here. In order to use the 34-330A low voltage burden current shunt, we would take the current measurement probes out, plug this into the voltage measurement, switch to voltage measurement, and then attach the current measurement terminals into the shunt. Now you can see that the current is much closer to the voltage applied to the 1 ohm load. It's 3.2 amps instead of 2.2 amps. And you can see that the voltage burden has been reduced from almost a volt down to 13 millivolts. This is very helpful in digital circuits because a lot of digital circuits wouldn't operate if the voltage was about a volt below what it's supposed to be. So in this case, we're able to maintain a very, very close approximation to the actual desired voltage using this low voltage burden current shunt. The other advantage of this current shunt is it also allows you to measure up to 15 amps, where the internal current measurement is only capable of going to 3 amps.